All right, guys, back at the base camp. And I wanted to get out as soon as I had the opportunity to say what's up and finish up this shelter here at the base camp. For any of you guys that are new to the channel,
look at that shelter, boy. Look at that.
Man, I'm rusty with the camera work. Anyways. Whoa. Anyways, there's the shelter over there. And I'm done. I'm calling it quits. I came out here last December into this little private piece of property I have access to. And I thought, man, I want to put together a shelter. I come out here and shoot videos every week, and I want a place that's really a place I can look to as a base camp, something I can call home away from home. And what I really wanted was to just basically put together some type of permanent or semi-permanent shelter, a fire pit, an area for me to shoot videos, whether that was cooking, learning new skills, gear reviews, any of that kind of stuff. I wanted a backdrop, a place to do it. And I was inspired by a couple other people on social media, some Instagram stuff, some YouTube stuff, where I was like, man, these shelters really are cool. So I said, hey, let's build a shelter. So the first time I come out here, I really was just looking for a location. I was walking around these woods, trying to find a nice flat spot where there wasn't a whole lot of little trees I had to cut out or anything, but I wanted it in a high elevation, an area that wasn't gonna drain, have water draining onto it all the time, every time it rained, which certainly happens on this piece of property. I wanted to do it somewhere where there wasn't dead trees everywhere. For all you guys that know, these trees up here, they're wood. They're made of wood. Hack. If they die and they fall on you, they can kill you. So, it's called a dead standing tree. It's called a widowmaker. Married or not, one of these big trees falls on you in your sleep and you could die. It happens, I would say all the time, but every year I'm sure there's people who get with trees falling down because they didn't put together the smartest camp location. So I wanted to make sure that was my first priority, find a good site. So I picked this area right here. All right, so it's like right here, I saw these trees. Trees right here, trees right there. They're about 10, 12 feet apart. I thought it was a perfect distance for me to string a ridge pole across. And the basic premise of the shelter was just a lean-to. I wanted to make a lean-to because it seemed doable. It didn't seem too crazy. Seemed basic, like a good beginner shelter to build. So I went with a lean-to. Basically a lean-to is just like this. Leaning piece of wood up against the support beam. There's my support beam right there. To create a little bit of an area underneath for shelter. And the one thing I was concerned with was my height. I'm 6'4", so I wanted to make a big old shelter. And as you guys can see, this thing is grand. It is pretty big. I'm 6'4". So I needed this ridge pole to be about 7 foot, which is what I did. 7 foot ridge pole. And you guys can see from this point, where is it? Over there, where it's connected, all the way up to here, is probably about, it is 10 feet, because I have a 10 by 8 tarp. So there's pretty good space under here. I've got enough space to do carving, cooking, all kinds of stuff. It's awesome to have a shelter like this. But what I learned was invaluable. The first thing I came across was, I thought this would be easy. I thought all I had to do was find 20 pieces of wood, lean them up against a ridge pole, and I'd be ready to rock and roll with a bomb shelter. First problem I ran into was I realized that this is hardwood. Everything here is hardwood. There's maybe five pine trees on the property and 10 or 15 cedar trees. They're all live, doing well. I'm not gonna cut those things down. Plus, that's not enough to build with anyways. So what I ended up having to do was scour the property, searching for the straightest hardwoods that there were. And let me tell you, there weren't very many. There weren't any, barely. There was basically no dead standing trees that were straight enough to use for a good shelter. And I started to get down on myself, like, man, I wanted this to look so pretty and cool and awesome. At some point I realized that ain't gonna happen. So I moved forward using what I could find to make the shelter. And if you guys take a quick look, if you guys have been following along with the channel for any length of time, you realize this already, that this ain't the prettiest shelter on YouTube. It is the prettiest shelter in these woods though. So yeah, you guys can see these are the straightest pieces of wood I could find for the project. So as I came back out here as often as I possibly could for weeks, I was cutting long 8-foot sections of dead standing trees to use as my roof rafters. And my original idea was a lean-to with a wall, about a 2 or 3 foot wall in the back to give me more headspace when I was sitting in the shelter. Because when you see a lean-to, those pieces of wood that you're using for shelter basically go all the way to the ground. Problem with that is you lose a lot of space inside of that little bottom of the triangle. You lose a lot of space, you can't do anything with it. So I figured if I raise that up, put a little wall along the backside, I'd be getting some more head clearance. And it worked, but man, was that a lot of work. Not a lot of material around here, so making the project more difficult than it needed to be took some time. Definitely took some time. And then I decided I was gonna put up a sidewall. At some point early on, I put the sidewall up, I put a raised bed inside, and I built a little fire reflector. There's also a table back here where I can put all my gear on just to keep it out organized. It's very hard to find flat surfaces besides the ground out in the woods, so the raised bed and the little table were necessary, especially for food prep and stuff like that. Underneath of it, there's a little area to store firewood. Originally, I set out to do an all-natural shelter, and I think I started at the beginning of December, and I was like, I'll probably have it done by the new year so I can do some overnighters in the winter. It is September. It's taken me 9 months to do this, and I've put a lot of time into it. I can tell you guys that without using materials that are straight and close by, the project can take way longer than you think it would. If this was all pine and they were all over deadfall and stuff, it wouldn't have taken so long. But yeah, it's just rowdy. Had to use what I had and it took forever. But yeah, so at the end of the day, I'm done. You wanna know why? I had a grand plan for, walnuts. I had a grand plan. I was gonna put together cedar shingles. I was gonna finish this shelter. I was gonna put a couple roof beams across, and I was gonna put cedar shingles up. I was gonna make my own cedar shingles. And then at some point in the last couple months, I realized I don't wanna put any more work into this project. I failed the day I came out to start. I wanted to build a shelter that could stand up through the test of time, and I failed. I put it inside of a woodland packed full of dead trees. I don't know that there's anywhere here on property that would have been better, because whatever that bug is, the emerald ash borer beetle or something like that, it's destroying these woods. I'd say between 20 and 30% of these woods are dead. I've taken the drone, flown it above the property, and yeah, it's not good. The woods is destroyed. So, this tree right here, when I started building last winter, it looked like a tree that had just shed its leaves because it was the winter time. As you guys can see now, it's dead. It's a dead tree. And this is, I mean, my shelter's right here. So, one, right there, two, three, I can't even count to you guys how many dead ash trees are out here. There's way too many for me to want to put a whole bunch of time investing into building this thing back up, because it's gonna get landed on. It's just a fact. The tree's gonna fall and land on it in the next year or two and probably damage it. And hopefully I'm not sleeping under it when it happens. But so I've decided to call it quits and just get back to shooting regular videos. When I come out here, I wanna enjoy my time, cook some food, chill out, do overnighters. I don't wanna always have to be focused on building, so I'm done. What I did is, I finished securing these braces to the frame. I bought myself a cheapo tarp from Walmart. It's an 8x10, heavy duty nylon tarp in brown. So yeah, it's kind of woodsy. So yeah, I'm pretty much done, guys. I just want it to be waterproof so I can sleep out here. So, here's the shelter, guys. I probably will end up doing little things here and there, but As for the big projects, big camp projects, I'm just not gonna do it. The importance of this project to me was learning experience. I learned so much about how to build a shelter by kind of failing along the way, doing everything and making mistakes and having to learn from my own mistakes. I'm the type of person that has to physically do something and make a mistake to learn. I can't just read stuff out of a book and conceptualize it into an understanding I can implement. It doesn't work like that. But yeah, I just want to show you guys that quick little montage of me building the shelter over the last year. Tell you guys, I appreciate all the support. I really like doing the shelter build. And there's a lot of new people watching the channel, so I want to say welcome. Thanks for watching. And right now I'm gonna get some twigs together, some sticks. I'm gonna cook up a cheese pizza sandwich. If you've ever heard of that, I'm gonna try it out, see how it goes. Some twigs for a fire.
Look at that. Look at them feather curls, boy. Look at that. Look at them curls. Still got my skill. More 2000. Chill. The precise curl. Oh, man. It's like 50 little teeny curls.
Well, I got the fire built up big time, and I just want to cook the pizza over coals, so it's probably going to cook down over the next 20 minutes or so, and then I'll be ready to start cooking. Big time fire. Alright, never tried this before.
About to make me a pizza. Pizza, dude.
I brought some cheese, some sauce, and some crusts. Some crusts and some tinfoil. So obviously I'm not gonna be able to achieve like a real crisp crust like you like on a pizza, but you gotta crawl before you can walk. So what I'm gonna try to do is fashion together some type of pizza using just tinfoil.
Cheese pizza,
real simple, just to see how it turns out.
These are just pre-made, pre-bought, nah, I mean.
All right, the solution is gonna be two crusts. One on the top, one on the bottom. So I gotta put a bit of sauce on this one piece. It's like a pizza sandwich. Hopefully it works, because I'm getting hungry. Spread this out. Don't wanna go too wide. Don't want it to get all smushed and spill out the sides. It's looking pretty good. And put some cheese on it.
Look at the cheeses. Look at the cheesy boy.
So basically, I'm just gonna put all the cheese on it. All right, let's finish up. This is maybe one of the quickest, easiest, awesomest meals if it works. Put a little bit of sauce on this piece too. Back in the day, I had a job making pizzas. Whoops, put it on the wrong side. Not smart. But yeah, I used to make pizzas back in the day when I was in college. All right. Is that enough sauce? Yes, I don't want it to get crazy. Three, two, one, flip. Oh, baby. Check that out.
Look at the cheese coming out the ends.
I hope this turns out. I know it's not gonna be crisp. I think it's gonna be soft, I think. But as long as it tastes good, this is gonna be like a camping hack. Camp hack. No mess kit needed. Try to seal it up as best I can. Okay, I'm just bending up the edge of this tin foil around it to kind of keep it one gigantic pizza cookie sandwich. Did I lose you guys? I think you're under the tin foil now. Hold it. Keep it tight. Mamma mia, pizzeria, give me a pizza pie. Man, that looks good. I mean, you know what I mean. Pretty good bed of coals. They're not big chunks of coals, so it wouldn't be really ideal for like a steak, I don't think. But I burned a lot of wood to fill up that entire fire, little fire pit hole I dug. So yeah, it's a good bed of coals. Trusty little grill will help me elevate it up over the coals so it's not so, it doesn't cook so fast. All right, pizza's on. Pizza is on. I don't know how long to cook it. It's kind of like steak temperature, steak cooking temperature, hot. Put my hand above the coals for like 2 seconds and it was already hot. So probably gonna have to flip it a couple different times. Might as well flip it now. It's already been a couple minutes. Never done a pizza. Back in the day, one of the group mates, actually, I think every time I've ever camped with Kyle, he's cooked pizza on a little, actually the first time I think he cooked it on a little gas stove, and the other time I think he cooked it on a campfire. But it looked good when he did it. So hopefully this turns out good. Pizza sandwich, cheese pizza sandwich. So where have I been? Sorry for that background noise. It's the Argentinians. They're on to me. I wonder if anybody gets that. Does anybody know the Argentinians reference? Anyways, I haven't been doing any videos. It's been 2 or 3 months probably since the last video upload. And I've been traveling for work. I took a job just Indiana. It's about a 5-hour drive from where I'm at. But yeah, that's what's been taking up my time. Able to come home like every other weekend, every third weekend since I started the job about 2 months ago. But just not enough time for me to get out into the woods and shoot videos working this job. It's a temporary job. Should be ending this week, so I should be back around much more starting next week. But I've got a locked down permanent employment. So most of my time and energy won't be out here shooting videos because I got to earn a living. I gotta get a job, gotta get a career. Over the past, 10 years, I've had stable jobs. I took a different job that was less stable, 2 years ago? A year and a half ago? 2 years ago, something about that. Took a different job, a different position, because it was good for the resume and stuff. And it was a less stable position. Now I am kind of trying to figure out what to do, you know, what career move to make. I'm really interested in construction, residential housing, and building. I don't have a huge background in like building, obviously, as you can tell. But yeah, that's kind of what I want to do, is hop into residential home building. What I do now is all multifamily stuff. It's all apartment community, oversight and maintenance, renovations and stuff like that. But I want to find something in residential. And kind of what I wanted to do was, you know, start from the bottom. Something that doing this project has taught me is that I want to know how to build a house. Not so much this, not so much a wood, you know, log cabin, but using modern materials, modern tools, I want to learn how to build an off-grid cabin. Two birds with one stone if I can do that for a living. If I can figure out how to learn all that stuff, you know? I want to learn carpentry, I want to learn electric, then plumbing, and just see where it takes me. I want to learn it all, I want to know it all, but there's a lot to learn. It's working really good. There's little rocks in that little grill. It's working nice. So yeah, basically been traveling for 2 months. YouTube's on the back burner because I got to figure out how to make a living. I'm not able to be real committal with the YouTube stuff right now because, you know, the career is more important. But what I want to do is learn how to build my own off-grid cabin. And I mean, using modern tools and modern materials. Not as interested in doing things the hard way. I learned doing this using hand tools that I'm going to take advantage of all the modern technology we have. So hopefully in the next couple of years, I can get the point, my knowledge to the point, and my skill set and my free time and my money, all of that up so that I can potentially build a tiny home, off-grid tiny home. It's what I've always wanted to do. What I wanted to do with this channel when I first built it was learn the skills of self-sufficiency and self-reliance, growing your own food, building your own house, living off-grid. Lots changed in the last 4 years. I have a home now, so I doubt I'm going to be building a little tiny house to actually live in. That's where my brain's floating around. Housing. Structure building. The wood stuff's fun. Building this structure was a pretty good time, but I'm just interested in the next level, which is modern materials. I could definitely do better next time I build a shelter than this one. I learned a lot doing this build. I really did. But the next step would probably be to just use 2x4s, modern power tools. But I'll still be out here in the woods doing cooking videos and all kinds of stuff. I just don't know when. Till I settle in a career that is running smooth. Don't think I'll be able to get out here very often, guys. I want to get back to the Bushcraft A to Z series. It's a long series, 26 letters in the alphabet. I think I'm done 9 or 10 so far. But yeah, I just don't have the time. So I don't even know why I'm bouncing these ideas back and forth. I don't even know when I'll be able to get to it. Hopefully, I can prioritize some things and get some trips knocked out. So maybe not spending my weekends out here in the woods shooting videos, but maybe once a month or every other month, go out and do a video with another YouTuber, go do a couple overnights, a couple nights out in the woods, go out and actually do some overnighters and some traveling. Video quality high, awesomeness level higher, video upload lower, less often. Man, I'm getting hungry. So yeah, I'm thinking. I want to do videos, I want to travel, go meet up with those guys up north, Canada. Hopefully this fall we can get to another canoe trip. We'll see. I'm gonna go check that pizza. It should be done. It's been slow cooking for like 20 minutes probably. All right, what I think I'll do is now that it's probably cooked, heated up, cheese melted and that kind of stuff, I'll probably toss it in the coals to give it, try to like cook the crust, you know, char it up. Super stoked to be able to get outside, breathe in this fresh air, just get back to a video and relax for a bit out here. Trapped indoors all the time, not good for Mr. O. How about that TA Outdoors? Big Mike, what's up, man? If you're watching, really well done on the on the freaking hunting tower, man. Your videos have been keeping me sane. And Big Zed, Zed's shelter's on another level. Holy moly. So yeah, my shelter sucks. I've been watching these other guys' shelters and they are doing a kick butt job. Zed's shelter's looking real good. He just started, TA just finished, and his is, damn, it's crazy, it's sweet. Same type of stuff that inspired me to make a shelter, is stuff that was that good. First try, not too bad. At least I got a shelter. Be nice to sleep in it. Can't wait for that overnighter at the base camp. About to switch lenses. For any of you guys that are filming, FYI, I use three lenses. This is the standard stock 18 to 55 mil. It's nice because I can get a decent shot of myself, selfie style, but I can also zoom in and get some more cinematic shots. I've also got that long range zoom lens, which creates a really nice shot. This is a 75 to 300 mil lens. These are all real cheap lenses. Like if they are Canon, then I bought them used. And then I've also got this one. This is a Canon wide angle, 10 to 18 mil. I like using this when I'm in the shelter because it opens up, give you more of a view. So like right now, I'm zoomed out as far as I can go with the stock lens, and I'm about to switch to this lens. See how much wider of a view? It's a really good lens for outside, for videos outside. Capture the landscape. Nah, I mean. Also really good for interior photography for inside housing, inside houses, because if you need to take photographs inside of a house, you get like a big, wide view of it all. I like this. It's kind of like looking like a little vlog style. Little distortion, damn it, a little distortion, but I think it looks all right. All right, I'm thinking this pizza's got to be done. Who knows if it's any good, but we'll find out. All right, what I'm gonna do, open it up to let the humidity out. I'm gonna set it back on the coals, try to get a bottom crunch, at least get the crunch on the very bottom of it. This is what it would look like without the wide angle lens, basically. This is what every shot would look like, unless I took it way back, but I don't use a mic, so the mic's right in the camera, so I gotta keep it close or else I'm screaming. So the wide angle allows me to open up and get you that shot, which I just think is cooler when you can see, you know, kind of the environment that you're in. Got the haircut, got the beard trimmed and everything. Got my favorite blue shirt on. This blue shirt is the only one. My Clint voice. This. No voice. Blake rakes cakes. This blue shirt is the only one I own. How's the warm up? This blue shirt is the only one I own. I suck at singing. It's the only one I own. I'm scrambled, oh. All right, pizza was in. I just set it in the coals for like another minute. I'd rather have a soft pizza than a burnt pizza, so it's time to chow on down. All right, here's the pizza. The pizza sandwich. It's probably 1,000 degrees. Oh yeah, crispity on the bottom. Nice. What? Nice. Question is, do I wanna cut it?
Might as well do that.
All right, it smells kind of like a quesadilla, which means I did get some good crisp crunch on the bottom. This is like a pizza quesadilla. The fact that I came up with this and I'm the first person in the world to do it, pretty awesome, huh? Oh yeah. Oh,
look at it. Ah,
ah, it's hot, freak. Oh, it's spilling too. Check this out. Oh my God, this is perfect.
Look at it. Look at that pizza, boy. Look at the browning. Get off me.
So it cooked perfect. This side got nice crunch to it. You can see we got all kinds of cheese coming out.
Man, that's gonna be good.
Question is it gonna be too hot? Oh my good, it's good. It is hot, really hot. I'd qualify this as a camping hack. That's why they call it a mess kit, thought does is make a mess.
It's a hack. Gimmick hack. Life hack. Look at that flavor bowl. Look at all that flavor in that thing.
See that? It's all brown and crispity up there. All crispity. All that cheese and that tomato sauce. And then this side's a little soft, but it ain't too bad. This is good, tastes good, it's easy to make, there's no cleanup at all. This is automatically being propelled into like one of my favorite camping meals. All the way up. I'm not a big fan of doing dishes. Even when I'm at home, I got a sink. So, going out in the woods, if you can figure out a way to cook good food without having to clean up, it's an added bonus. Bacon, some crispy bacon to put in this would be great. All right, tip number one on making the pizza quesadilla, is use less sauce than you think you would. Oh, cheese dangler. Because you can always dip this in sauce afterwards, which is nice and clean. If you put too much sauce and too much cheese on this thing, when you bite it, it comes out the other side. I'm just trying to be neat, you know what I mean? Don't want to have food slopping all over the place. Another thing, some Italian seasoning would be good on this. And some garlic and some butter. Pepsi would be killer right now. Or Mountain Dew. Good bite. So if you're not like a big eater, not a big appetite, just take one of these, fold it over on itself, and it's basically a whole pizza. I'm pegging out. Going into a food coma. Almost halfway done. I'm getting full. My point of view. Oh boy. All right, well, it's been 20 minutes since I took the pizza. I'm full, real full. That's too much food. But sun's going down. Man, it's beautiful out. Look at this. Look at that beauty. Look at the beauty.
Look at that beauty, boy. Look at that sunset.
All right, guys. That does it for me today. Just glad to get back out here to the campsite. Cooking, food, YouTube. I'm pooped now. A little rusty with the camera work. Sorry if the video is not of normal quality.
Sweet. Look at them shrooms, boy.
I don't know what those kind of shrooms are. Anyways, it's Sunday, or it's Monday, Labor Day. Happy Labor Day, everybody. So, I'm gonna get out of here, try to get back home, edit, film, and upload this video tonight before work tomorrow. Because I have no idea when I'll be able to get back to it after that. So I appreciate you guys watching. Hope you stick around. Until next time, Scrambled O, signing off.